coisa mais linda, mais cheia de graça. Ela menina que vem de casa.
Take a seat. The doctor's with another patient. Esse balanço caminho.
Moça do corpo dourado, do sol de Ipanema. O seu balançado é mais que um poema. É a coisa mais linda que eu já vi passar. Ah, por que estou tão sozinho? Ah, por que tudo é tão triste? Beleza que não é só minha, que também passa sozinha.
Yes, I am a herpist.
Se ela soubesse que quando ela...
No, I don't know where Power Man is. We're partners, not a couple.
Yeah, I know that. I'm a superhero too, named Laranya.
Shouldn't you call yourself something like Spider-Girl? Aren't your powers just like Spider-Man's?
Yeah. I didn't want anybody to think that I was Spider-Man's sidekick.
Good call. That guy talks too much.
I know, right?
Pulled a hammy, fight a bunch of ninjas. You?
Mace in the face. I'm not talking the stuff that old ladies carry either. Like, straight up frickin' medieval weapon.
Who was it? You mean cannibal?
No, some doof calling himself a supervillain. Real over the top nut job with the whole "why the government" thing going on.
Ah, Flag Smasher.
Yeah, that's it. Anyway, I got in a little over my head when Spider-Man swung it. Saved me just in time. Saw that I was hurting and gave me the address of this joint. He didn't give me much details, but I'm guessing there's a doctor here. I mean, I guess my health insurance through my dad or whatever would cover this, but this is a little hard to explain to a regular doctor.
Don't sweat, kid. This is where all the masks in New York City come for a little TLC.
But who?
Just call the night nurse. She's experienced and seen it all. Luckily for us, she offers her services free and discreetly, as like a repayment to the heroes in the area.
But why a place like this? Isn't this a little unhygienic?
You just got hit in the face with a mace. Be more afraid of the germs than that thing.
Fair point.
Besides, can't really have us walking in with the civilians. I wouldn't want the nurse to be seen with the mask. So, yeah, it looks shady, but that's because we're all laying low.
I guess that makes sense. So what, she just helps any hero that walks through that door?
From what I've seen, obviously some heroes are going to need more help than others. I wonder what she's seen to walk through that door.
Job's in the bag, sir.
Really, Brigham? You broke into the Sanctum Sanctorum?
Like you wanted me to. And honestly, it wasn't that hard.
What would you have me do, Wong?
It was way harder breaking into the Baxter building last year. Magic types are always way more lax with their security than you would think.
So you really did it, huh? You broke in there, you stole the elixir without running into the good doctor?
Well, I encountered the good doctor, all right. He's dead in the dial-up now.
What? How'd you get in here?
I'm taking that serum, stranger. He made a move against me, so I took him down. Rules of engagement and all that.
Brigand, you're very little more than a common thief. You're telling me you killed the Sorcerer Supreme?
I'll bring the right tools for the job. A pistol from our favorite Nazi, firing silver bullets,
went right through his defenses. He's not a fucking werewolf, fucking moron. Unless you stuck around to carve out his still beating heart, you've just pissed him off.
Whatever. You wanted me to bring you the vial? Brought you the vial. What are you even gonna do with it? Sell it?
Drink it? Oh, brigand. I'm gonna study it. And if this vial is what I think it is, I'm gonna pour it down the drain.
Are you the night nurse?
I was told to bring you here to her.
Yes, I am. And you are?
My name is Wong. Someone broke into our home and shot my master right in front of me.
Take a deep breath, Mr. Wong. And who is your friend here?
This handsome devil is Dr. Stephen Strange.
What the? Your...
Pleasure to finally meet your acquaintance.
You're a...
Natural projection, not a ghost. Not yet. Well, I may stay like this if my body continues bleeding all over your table.
Okay. Even though I have seen many things, I am still a human.
My apologies. I only meant to offer my services as a fellow doctor.
What's like?
Dr. Strange is being positive, but all servants to masters and mystic arts carry the universal donor, so I should be of use.
Fine. How about medical history? Any major surgeries?
Just one. Car crash. Left permanent nerve damage to my hands. From one of the finest surgeons in the world to never be able to steady a scalpel was a humbling experience. Back then, I was an arrogant wretch. So I should be lucky that the crash only took my hands. However, I tried to find a way to fix my hands, which led me to finding a mystic in the mountains of Tibet named the Ancient One. He taught me something far greater than a cure for my hands. I found myself, my purpose. I became the master of the mystic arts and became the Earth's new Sorcerer Supreme.
You're serious? You call yourself the Sorcerer Supreme? And you say you used to be arrogant?
Old habits die hard. Now careful. Another millimeter and you'll open my aorta.
Thanks, Doc. But you know, you're not the only doctor in the room. Night nurse is just catchier than night general practitioner.
I am aware of your credentials, my dear. A brilliant young medical student once rescued by one of the city's costume champions. And she therefore dedicates her life to their care, yes. A skilled physician and surgeon, yet secretly dreams one day becoming a superhero herself.
I have no interest in ever joining your little club, Strange.
Of course. I'm sure the cape is just part of your Florence Nightingale fetish.
I am holding a scalpel next to your heart. Besides, I don't think someone with his own personal slave boy should have any room to talk about someone else's fetishes.
You will address Wong with respect. Enough of that.
No, this is my fault. If I did not have this terrible condition, then you would not have had that elixir in your possession. Then that burglar would not have come.
Wong!
I'm okay. Just a dizzy spell from the blood loss. Please, the master still needs your attention.
I don't understand. If he found some sort of magic potion for your pal, why is he still sick?
I may be the master of mystic arts, but I'm also a licensed caregiver. I couldn't risk prescribing this drug until I had tested it first for safety and effectiveness. I sent a sample to a research buddy of mine, an old friend. I received only the results this afternoon, before the robbery, and before I could have a chance to administer the serum to Wong.
Somebody want to steal a sick man's medicine.
Because... from the results, it turns out that the elixir is considerably more powerful than I anticipated.
It's not a remedy for a single rare illness. Thank you again for your excellent service, Night Nurse. I know you do not accept payment, but I would like to offer some sort of repayment.
Doctor, we aren't done here. You can't just check yourself out.
Firstly, call me Steven. Secondly,
why not?
For the love of God, you've been shot!
By some glorified bike messenger. Real worry is what he will do. We cannot let it fall into the wrong hands. There are many who would want to profit off the cure for cancer. As much as I would like to spread a cure for cancer freely and save untold millions of lives, I cannot be sure this world is even ready for such a thing. There is still much I need to research to ensure its safety on a global level. There is always a risk when magic is involved. I must protect this world.